Just drunk.
It's really tough to describe a game like Harvest Moon. I mean, you can, obviously, but it would sound like the most boring game ever. Raising livestock, planting and watering crops, doing farm stuff. But this game is a classic case of the whole being greater than the sum of its parts. Harvest Moon is sort of like if SimCity were an RPG. The premise of the game is that you take over your grandpa's farm and try and rejuvenate it while keeping your father's approval, and in the meantime, you can get married and have kids and all that. It's a precursor to the Animal Crossing series, where you build your own nice cozy little world within a certain set of specific parameters, of course, and you really just hang out. If there's one word to describe Harvest Moon, it's relaxing. Tired of boss fights, random battles, and evil villains trying to take over the world, then Harvest Moon is the change of pace you're looking for. Now, whether you like Harvest Moon or not depends on what you want to get out of playing a video game. If you like taking your time and building things like SimCity or Populous, you'll enjoy this game, but if this all sounds as boring as watching crops grow, which you'll be doing a lot of in this game, then yeah, avoid Harvest Moon. I guess it's a little like choosing between playing with exciting toys like Nerf guns or action figures or whatever, and putting together a 2,000-piece puzzle. Harvest Moon is very good for what it is. It looks great, and everything is reasonably intuitive. You start out with some money which allows you to buy seeds, livestock, tools, and talk to whoever to gather information. Then you gotta remove tree stumps, rocks, and other random crap in your way. Then you gotta work the land and make the soil good enough for planting. Then you gotta go to sleep, and then you get up and do more of the same. The game rewards you for keeping a strict routine. Do stuff the same way at the same time every day, and you'll have success. I guess a more cruel way of saying this is that the game rewards you for being boring. But I don't really see it that way. It's kind of cool to see your farm grow the more work you put into it. But staying on that point, one thing I enjoyed about SimCity, for instance, was doing the exact opposite of what you were supposed to do. Pissing off the SimCity guy was funny, for me anyway, and summoning disasters like a Bowser attack was hilarious. Don't expect the same kind of flexibility in Harvest Moon. For a simulation game, it's pretty linear, and it doesn't allow you to screw around. That's unfortunate. The inherent flaw with the gameplay here is that the music is so repetitive. They blew an opportunity to create a really good soundtrack here, similar to SimCity. The music is good enough, but you get sick of it very quickly. But if you're up to playing this game, there's 30 days to a season, and the game lasts nearly 3 years. And in the meantime, like I mentioned earlier, there's also kind of a side quest that involves starting a family. This is hilariously straightforward. You read each girl's diary, where they explicitly say what they want, and then you give it to them. And just like that, they fall in love with you. Oh, okay, it's that easy, is it? This really doesn't change your farm or anything a whole lot, but I thought it was a pretty funny feature to have. So is Harvest Moon worth picking up for the Super Nintendo? Of course not, are you insane? The cart costs like $150 on average. Get it on the Virtual Console instead. Or if you really insist on having a hard copy, get the Game Boy version. It's actually a pretty faithful port, although its world is obviously a bit compromised. Anyway, yeah, just understand what you're getting into when you play Harvest Moon for Super Nintendo. It's not your usual RPG or simulation style game, but it is worth checking out to see if you like it or not.